map. This map, well, if you start this map from scratch, it's gonna be pretty tough to get on that first quest. You're gonna fly through this map. As you can see, the part-time, I could not get the part-time to change at all. If I could, I would definitely, because especially this map, you can finish this map a lot less than 8 minutes and 30 seconds. Yeah, this map is not that long. It's kind of small, like most of my maps have been in Wolfenstein 3D 2. This map is small. It could be a little bit tough though, because of the amount of Schustoffels and officers. I mean, it has some guards in it, but it's not that hard. What we've learned in this, most of these maps, is that as the game goes on, the number of harder enemies to defeat, excluding the mutants, of course, that's only in episode 2. But excluding the mutants, most of the guards afterwards are Schustoffels and officers. If it wasn't for that, that would probably make these maps harder than they could be. Even the fact that most of them are pretty easy. Compared to ultimate challenges maps. Yeah, I mean, these maps are such disappointment. And I did not realize that at all when I was younger, but I feel like these maps could have been a lot harder, especially this one. For being a final level before a boss battle, this map was not that hard. It wasn't completely straightforward, but I still think this map could have been better. I wanted to make a nice maze, but of course, I made a pretty straightforward maze with one crappy long hallway that leads to a random dead end with just a secret area. I got better as a result of the challenge. Now move on to Floor 9, which is the final floor in Wolfenstein 3D 2. And of course, after this, as you know, we will go back to Island of Death's levels, which those maps are meant to be harder. Some are, some of them are still going to work. In fact, some of them were worse than Wolfenstein 3D 2. But you'll see that. Until then, I am the Club of the Man 1993.